Thank you. Go that way. Go that way. Kevin?
Mrs. Stenison is going to take care of you. Okay?
Alright?
Mrs. Stenison is going to take care of you. Hurry up.
Speaking against his very own father that way. I would rather be drawn and quartered than think that I was in any way responsible for what happened next. After all, I am just an ordinary housewife and mother, just like all these housewives and mothers out there. Word had come to me that Pippin was holding a secret meeting of a treasonous nature.
Revolution!
Hello, Pippin.
Power!
We pledge to stand by Pippin forever!
Now, revolutionaries, let me first say that I admire the dedication and courage which has brought you here this evening.
Forever!
Thank you. Second, let me be honest about some of the dangers which may lie ahead.
Yeah!
If during this insurrection any one of us is caught, the king's vengeance will be swift and terrible. You will undoubtedly be tortured, broken on the wheel, cruelly maimed, even dismembered.
Get that!
But I'm sure that the prospect of these terrible agonies will not deter you from joining me in. They may seem right now, but once the deed is done, once action against the king is taken, they will flock to my side. Maybe.
Oh!
Mama, if Pippin kills father,
you'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
And if father discovers Pippin's plan and executes him,
you'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
No matter what happens, I'm moving on up.
Yes, darling.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, but my lord, you
You always feel so much better after your yearly prayer on the 15th.
Yes, I do, don't I?
I sought out Pippin. Your father, he loves you, Pippin.
Freedom and dignity for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Look at Jim. Your name will be on his lips when he prays. At Arles, next month.
He prays at Arles next month?
Alone and unguarded.
Alone and unguarded? What date?
The 15th.
What time?
When the cock crows. Pippin, I beg you to bring this stranger to an end.
I intend to.
Shall I tell your father this is
No. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? No, isn't that sweet? Your intentions make me very happy, Pippin.
You've been a great help to me, Pastrana.
Oh, what sweet words can mother hear.
I know the parables told in the Holy Book. I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm really helping myself.
I'm off to Arles to pray.
Goodbye, my lord.
Goodbye, my lady.
Oh, dear. In the hustle and bustle of my lord's departure, I completely forgot to warn him.
Shucks.
Oh, my. What a busy day. Events move so swiftly that it's hard for a simple woman like me to keep up. But one day, soon, able to say what every mother wants to be able to say. My son, the king. And if we are, what a little sunshine, oh, beneath a helping hand, we hope.
After all, I am just an ordinary housewife mother, just like all you ordinary housewife mothers out there. Do 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 do.
It's all right, Father. You may come in.
I'm sorry to disturb you. I know you like to pray alone, my son.
You know who I am, Father?
Of course, my son.
Then you want something from me, perhaps? A favor? An advancement?
No.
Then what, Father?
I'm here to be with you for a moment. Touch you. Look in your eyes.
And what do you see?
Two eyes. A little cloudy with age. A sunset.
What else?
The death of thousands, the slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see that in my eyes?
You deny it?
Deny it? I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos. If slavery, blood, and death are part of that order, so be it.
But those are words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son.
Yes, Father.
It's easy from where you stand to judge things that I have done. But when I marched, the dust of the road was in my nose, and when I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. I sank in the mud of the shores of the Volga. I drowned two legions in the Vistula. Why, eagles, ospreys, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things are very clear. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent and achieved an empire with it.
That was beautiful, Tom.
You liked it?
I loved it.
Oh, thanks.
You are welcome.
So, if you have no further business with me, go and leave me to my prayers.
What do you pray for, Father?
Strength, and may God give you the same.
That's okay. I brought my own. Why will my hand stop shaking when all the earth is still? When ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need taking, so many plans need making. I think I will.
Your Majesty.
Your Majesty.
Your Majesty. Your Majesty.
Your Majesty. Your Majesty. Your Majesty.
Sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due. Morning glow, fill the earth. Come and shine for all your worth. Will be present and above earth, of old faith looking new. Morning glow is long past due.
Treasurer,
I him to distribute money to the poor.
King Pippin!
The charitable!
Sire, I'm a peasant, a simple worthy man. I own a 1 millimeter mitten on which I've worked so hard on all my life. Is that fair?
No, that's terrible, but I will do something about it. I hereby decree that from now on, all peasants will own the land that they cultivate.
King Pippin!
The just!
Charles? Oh my god!
Sire, the royal treasury has refused me my last
gift. Mine too.
Oh, come on, you two. From now on, all royalty, including myself, will forego luxury and extravagance.
Isn't that a crock?
Oh.
King Pippin, the humble.
Sire, now that you've given the land to the peasants, we royals will have no source of income if we can no longer pay our taxes.
Well, then I hereby abolish taxes.
Without taxes, you won't be able to afford an army.
That's okay. I don't need an army. That's it. No more taxes, no more army.
King Pippin, the peaceful.
Sire, it is our duty to inform you that the infidel Hun has attacked me. He has destroyed 3 villages. He has hundreds of women and children.
Can he do that?
But he will withdraw on one.
Oh, well, that's very reasonable. I'm certainly willing to make any small concession. What's the condition?
Leave your head on a pipe.
Oh, well, in that case, I guess we'll just have to go out and destroy the infidel!
Hooray!
Excuse me a moment. Noble, do you remember that decree I made a little while ago about land and taxes?
Yes, sir.
That's off.
You mean you want me to pay taxes and raise an army?
Yes, that's right.
But sir, without land, I neither money nor power over the peasants.
Oh, well, that's a very good point. I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? Why does it not work for the poor to hand us from the royal treasury?
I bet he says you're absolutely right.
You're absolutely right. I hereby revoke charity to the poor.
Sire, what have you been drinking?
Take that girl away and hang her. Oh! No, wait, stop. Could you just let me think for a moment, please?
Oh, but he wants to think!
Darling, you're doing a wonderful job. Nothing has changed since your father died. Now, about my royal allowance.
Deny.
Yes!
Deny! Everybody out of my chapel. I want to pray.
Yes! Yes!
King Pippin, the unpopular.
Yes, he is.
Pray for the king.
What on earth would you pray for?
Strength.
Hello?
Hello?
I heard you become king.
Yes, that's right.
Well, since you become king, you put my head back on my shoulders.
I'm sorry, I don't think I can.
They all say that.
It's not that easy.
I knew you'd be just like the others.
You don't understand. There are certain things I just can't do.
What were you praying for?
I wish I could give my father his job back.
Is that what you want, baby? You want it? You got it.
I'm sorry, Father.
Okay, just don't let it happen again.
Well, nothing turns out the way I thought it would. I'm getting old. Very old. And I still haven't done anything with my life.
But you will!
Uh-oh, you will.
Now?
We need to get
now. You're on the ride to rap.
Kennedy.
Enter! Catherine! A widow! With a small boy and a large estate.
Well, first off, I've been coming around the world like a discarded rag. I would have passed him by. Perhaps I should have passed him by. But there was something about his foot. Yes, it was the arch of his foot that caught my eye. What I did was merely an act of Christian charity. After all, how could I have known that this discarded rag would clean up so well? There he was. He didn't know where he was. And he looked so lost and exhausted. You don't swear he was dead. So I said, pick him up. Put him to bed. See that he is bathed and clothed and fed. As I said, how could I foretell that he would clean up oh so very well? Imagine my surprise when I raised my eyes, and there he was. The man had obviously lost the will to live. So the first thing I had to do was get him interested in something. Something that would restore his faith in life. Something like me. Well, Pippin, I'm sure there are many things you'd like to know about me, aren't there?
No.
Good. My name is Catherine. I'm a widow. I have a son, and I own this estate.
On your average, ordinary kind of woman, common sense and every decade or so, I'm your everyday, customary kind of woman, practical as always, modest to a fault, conformity with a budget, liberal with a view, just your average ideal. My telling you this may seem sudden and strange. It may not interest you much at all right now, but things change, things change. Still I don't understand if I'm not your terrible mistake, and I know special glamour, no bait I can endure, or just a plain, everyday commonplace, come what may, average, ordinary,
lovable duck.
something you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance. Please, Pippin, please.
All right. You see, I have this overwhelming need to be completely fulfilled. And, well, it's never, ever happened to me. So I'm in abject despair.
And that's it?
Yes, that's it.
You may think I'm going to next week. Steam. Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. My husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day, he was struck by fever. When his hand went cold in mine, I felt that my life too was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. It took my bed for 5 days. But on the sixth day, I got up. There were things to be done, and a state to be run, a boy to raise. Well, look at that. I think he's really moved. Pippin, this is such a large state. I'm all alone here, and I can't do all this work by myself. Would you please help me?
Hold up! What was that? Did you not read the script? It says, speak the lie naggingly. Naggingly! Do it again!
Yeah.
Pippin, this is such a large state. I'm all alone here and I can't do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right. But just for a little while.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working. And slowly, he became part of everything. Part of our everyday lives.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day, isn't that exciting? Did you say something?
No.
I know that look. That look of a widow with a small boy in a large state and no one to sit at the head of the table.
For a while, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm for the work. But as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
Shh. Keep up the good work, boys. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Oh, wait a minute, Pippin, there is something. The roof of the chicken house, it's sprinkling. If you can get to it tomorrow.
Wait a minute.
Or the day after tomorrow.
The roof on the chicken house? I used to be the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire. So I screwed up. Still. Patching the roof and pitching the hay is not my idea of a perfect day. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you think about extraordinary things. That's the reason I'll never be the kind of man who dwells on how moss got into the tapestry or why the dungeon smells. Oh, it's hard to feel special, it's hard to feel big, feeding the turtle and walking the pig. It's so secondary to someone who is very extraordinary like me. Well, if the mold won't stop leaking and the goat won't stop shrieking and the griffin keeps losing its hair, if the west wing is rotting and our best wine is clouding, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. Someone who lives all of his life in superlatives. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. The fact that I'm different is easy to see. So why doesn't anybody know it but
ordinary things. Every so often a man has a day he truly can't call his. Well, here I am to seize my day. If someone would just tell me where the hell it is. Oh, give me my chance and give me my wings. And don't make me think about everyday things. They're unnecessary to someone who is very extraordinary.
And then, Theo's dog got sick.
Pippin, I was sick!
That's too bad, Theo. I'm sorry.
Pippin, this is the first time he's come to your house.
Could you look at him, please?
Theo, I don't know anything about dogs.
Pippin, try!
All right, let me have a look at him.
Now, say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck. There's nothing I can do for him. Oh, wait, Theo. Yes, there is. Come over here and kneel down next to me.
It was like a painting. Man and boy at prayer.
God, I know this is gonna sound ridiculous, but this boy really loves this duck. His breath has ebbed. His pulse is low, his feet are wet, but even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we've kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck or run amok to prayer we've stuck. Please reward our pluck and save this dog.
They prayed all day, and then, just after sunset, the duck died.
Wait, Theo, we can go to the pond and get another duck. Why'd the stupid duck have to die anyway?
Then, an interesting thing happened. Theo plunged himself into monumental despair, and Pippin, that very prince of despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirits.
Hey, Theo, we're going out to thrash some grain, and we need another good man. Want to give us a helping hand? Another time, maybe.
But Pippin showed remarkable persistence. When one thing failed, he tried another.
Hey, Theo, want to be the tallest little boy in the world? 5, 4, 4. I smell the blood. Here, I made you a stilt. You can be taller than anyone.
Well, most other men would have given up. But Pippin, with amazing perseverance, tried yet another way.
Hey, Theo, you're never gonna guess what I have for you now. I'm gonna bring it right down to you. Okay, when I count to three, look. 1, 2, 3, look.
That's not a duck, dummy.
Did I say it was a duck? Yeah, go on, you were a flop.
The season changed, as it always does. And every day was filled with those everyday things. Seeds to be sown, fences to be mended, and finally, of course, a love song to be sung.
Leaves in a home.
Because we've got a surprise for you.
We've got a surprise.
We got a surprise. Close your eyes now. No peeking.
Okay, but I usually don't like surprises.
Well, you like this one.
Can I open my eyes yet?
Go ahead. Quince pudding flambé. Oh, I haven't made it for years, but I thought for this special occasion.
What special occasion?
Well, 6 months ago today, you arrived here. So Theo and I thought we'd celebrate with a little party. So I made this and Theo made your food.
Here.
Oh, Theo, thank you. It's beautiful. I don't know what to say.
Well then, let me say something. In the 6 months that you've been with us, a lot of water has flown under the dam.
Over the dam. Water flows over a dam.
When I look into his eyes, I seem to get a bit confused.
You tried sticking to the part, sweetheart.
In the 6 months that you've been with us, a lot of water has flown over the dam. So I just want to say for me, for Theo, that, well, you've contributed a great deal to us. And now, well, now we have so many great years ahead of us. Well, isn't anyone going to eat my pudding?
I am!
I've got to get out of here.
Pippin, what's the matter?
I just can't stay.
I don't understand.
I've got to leave.
Why?
Because life is more than leaking roofs and ducks that die and flaming quince pudding.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. And I don't want to be stuck doing the same damn thing every day. Don't you see? There has to be something more than this. There has to be.
But what if there isn't anymore?
I know there is.
I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day, he was struck by fever. And in his hand, and cold his arm, I felt the mind that chose to learn. Took my bed for 5 days. But on the 6th day, I got up. There were things to be done. And a stage to be done. A boy to raise.
Wait, Kevin, don't go! I love you! Could you hold the light for a minute, please?
I guess I'll miss the management. If you can, his face was far from fine. But still I'll miss his face and wonder.
What are you
if
doing?
He's missing
mine. You're not supposed to be out here. What about the finale?
Yes, he wouldn't say. All day, some days, he's got that curse. But there were the days when he was really even worse. Some men are heroes, some men outshine the sun. Some men are simple good men. This man wasn't one. And I won't miss his wounds, his gray solitudes, his blunt of racist style. But please don't get me wrong, he was the best to come along in a long, long world.
And the arch was what really was in the class all by itself.
Thank you. going to.
Everything fails at one time or another.
Isn't that true?
Nothing has been completely fulfilling. Now has it, Pippin? Has it?
No, I guess there is nothing.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, there is something!
There is?
Why, how has it?
What is it?
Why, the only completely perfect act in our repertoire. The finale!
The finale!
That's the finale. What's supposed to happen?
You see, you will become part of that.
You mean, you want me to set myself on fire?
You will step into the flame, Pippin. Become part of the flame. Be engulfed by the flame. Become the flame itself!
And for one moment, shine with unequaled brilliance.
And in that flame, you will become a glorious synthesis of life and death.
And life again!
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the great Pippin in the grand finale act, never before seen on a public stage.
No, wait, look! If this finale is so spectacular, why doesn't one of you do it?
That's cute. That's really cute. But you see, we're just ordinary, run-of-the-mill people. Just your everyday men and women that keep this old world spinning. Heck, we're nothing. But you, Pippin, you are an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams.
You deserve a magnificent climax, an unparalleled finale.
Why? It's everything you've been looking for.
Out.
think about your life. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted
such a little thing from life. I want it so much.
Pippin, do you feel like you've compromised?
No.
Do you feel like a coward?
No.
Then how do you feel?
Trapped.